When I was testing a piece of track on the main line earlier in another video, I happened to grab this particular gondola off a back track, which I'd forgotten was a repair track, and tried to use it to test how smooth running the track was, and I just couldn't get it to freely roll. I should be able to give this a nudge and it just roll right off the end of that, but it's not. So I'm going to take a couple minutes and figure out why. So I'll flip that sucker over. Actually, before I even take the trucks off, I'm just going to push down on them as if it would be when it was... Oh, yeah, there we go. Yeah, the outer axle on both of them, both trucks, are the rim of the wheel is rubbing on the underside of the car. So KD sells some spacer washers to space the trucks up and lift them up a little bit in various thicknesses. I don't have any of those. It's Sunday. The hobby shops are closed anyway. So I think I'm going to come up with something, maybe a thin sheet of plastic or something. But first, let's put this back on the track. And get my coupler gauge. Yet another KD thing. That's designed specifically for aligning couplers. I'm going to bring the camera down closer here. There, that's better. So, there's a few different things about this coupler gauge. There's this little shelf here, and the trip pin is supposed to ride up over that comfortably. And then the center, the knuckle is supposed to center onto that one as well. So that trip pin's sitting a little low. Oops. And even with it up there, the coupler is a little low against the gauge, which means it's not going to hurt anything if I shim the truck up, which is going to essentially let the car with its couplers sit a little bit higher. So, how far is that? I don't know. I'm going to find some thin plastic and see what I've got in stock to make a shim out of. That. That is 20 thousandths. What's this one here? There, that's 15 thou. That's the thinnest piece that I've got, so I think I'll use it. Never know where you're going to find your sources of materials, but that's 15,000, so I'm going to use that. For this, I've got a set of hollow punches here that I bought eons ago, probably at Princess Auto or some other fine tool retailing establishment. A piece of hardboard as a backer, and a couple of different sizes of punch. What does that one say? That's 1/8. That's 1/4. Punch them concentrically. That should make a washer. Doing a bunch of them because this is completely eyeballing and there's no guarantee that I'm going to get them concentric. Although that's not bad. But no. There's a pokey pokey tool here. Yeah, that's not bad. It's a little off, but it's not going to be an invisible location. That one's fairly close. Well, no, they're not awesome, but... That one's pretty good. And another one, a fourth one, just for good measure. It's not like it's a really expensive source of material. There we go, there's... There's four of them. Okay, back to the other workshop. I'm back over here. So I think I'm going to start with those two. Just because they're the closest to concentric. I'll flip this guy over and pull the trucks off now. These just come off with one little Phillips screw. Oh, sorry. Ah! I'm trying not to do this with both hands in between the camera and what I'm working on. Okay then. I'm also trying to stop saying things like that. That's not quite the right size. So where's something to adapt the size of the hole with? A slightly conical round file. There's that motion again. Oops. And the other thing I want to do is smooth any burrs off the face of it. Let's see now then. Oh, ho, ho. Beautiful. Same again the other one. Since I'm expanding the size of the hole anyway, I'm going to work towards the slightly fatter side, which will make it more concentric. And then if these don't do the job, if they're a little too thin, then I can always go back to that piece of 20 thou plastic that I found. Okay. Set that guy back down there. And this one. Okay. Let's flip that back up onto the track. Get on there, you. Oh, oops. There, look at that. It actually coasts now. Wheels aren't binding, and let's see what that looks like. Now that the camera's down at a good angle, and you can see what's going on, the trip pin just clears the lip. And that is so close to centered on the gauge coupler. Beautiful. Job done.